There's a desperate need for more Māori and Pasifika to donate blood, and it's something Pio Terei knows all too well. That's why over the weekend, Pio and his beautiful wife Debbie's trust, Taina Trust, held a blood drive. The trust is named after their son who lost his battle with acute myeloid leukaemia. Working with the Wānanga o Aotearoa and NZ Blood, they wanted to encourage Māori and Pasifika to donate blood and ultimately create a space where everyone feels comfortable to donate. The reality is they will save lives by doing so. Registrations for the drive on Saturday were through the roof. Through the roof. So here to talk more about this kaupapa and how the event went is my beautiful friend Pio Terei.
Tēnā koe. I was reading the audio cue and you said, my beautiful wife, Debbie, she'll appreciate that. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I just wanted to show off my T-shirt, the ultimate koha.
I love it.
Yeah.
So how did the drive go on Saturday? Because it was in Kirikiriroa, yeah, in Hamilton.
Yeah, and big ups to the wānanga for creating a really warm, positive space for our whānau. There wasn't showers, it was like... it was a weather bomb.
Yeah.
Okay. And people just kept coming and coming and coming. The people who had registered,
yeah,
and also people who just got on board to support us. And I think when we look back and break it down, we created a safe space, yeah, for our whānau to go, this feels cool. I understand the story. It's an environment where I feel comfortable. It's not so clinical. And the results are, it went through the roof. We're so blessed to have that sort of reaction.
So, I mean, that was the drive on Saturday, but
yeah,
this is an ongoing thing,
yeah,
right? Even though everything was geared towards Saturday. So, and you only go where you want to go, Pio, but tell us about why you're at this stage in terms of why it's important to you and Deb, and the story with your boy,
yeah,
Taina, and why we're at this point.
Yeah, I think the thing that really rocked our socks, Deb and I, is the fact that blood's just part of the journey. Okay, we're not telling people what to do. We're asking them to do something based on some facts. And the facts are that if you have Pasifika Māori whakapapa, that means for bone marrow, okay, yeah, and blood's the first part of that, for bone marrow, we've got about 8,000 to 10,000 people in the library that if you need bone marrow, we can go to that library and try and find a match. If you have no Māori or Pacific Island whakapapa, the library is 20 million. Okay, so we're losing our whānau, ahakoa he tamariki he pakake, whether they're children, because there's not enough people on that bone marrow register. And they just take it out of your blood. They're not going to drill you in the arm or anything.
Yep.
So a lot of our whānau don't know about this. So Deb and I are on a journey to demystify the information, create a place where our people feel fine. When I say our people, all people.
Yep.
Okay,
cool.
Our whānau pākehā turned up too.
Yeah.
So they start with blood, we can have conversations about bone marrow. There are even people there talking about our organ donation because it's something that we don't do.
So if you have, you know, if we look back at Taina,
yeah,
with leukaemia,
yeah,
so in terms of the blood and the marrow that he could access,
yeah,
was between what, 8 to 10,000?
Yeah, if he was John Campbell's son, 20 million.
20 million.
That's a bad example. I don't want you, but you know what I mean.
Here, Pākehā.
Our Pākehā whānau. And so this is a process of, for Trust Taina, which is the name of the trust, we swapped it around because it sounds cooler, Trust Taina. This is a process of creating an environment where it's comfortable. You know, and you know what happened, sis? What happened was, is our people needed a waka to jump on to show how much they cared.
Mm.
And they just fronted up.
So I guess, and this was the interesting part for me, was listening to a podcast that you did, called Taringa Podcast, which is one I listen to regularly. And
yeah,
the conversation in there was around why there is a reluctance, perhaps, for our Māori and Pasifika people to give blood, to give bone marrow. And what came out of that was a beautiful kōrero.
Yeah.
And it's part of our history, right?
Yeah.
In terms of us being able to give.
Yeah.
And
tuku toto ai.
Yeah.
And to let the blood go.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so I guess that would have been an interesting conversation for yourself, but also to have when people arrive.
Yes.
To have that conversation with them.
Yeah, totally. And you know, for people with cultural whakaaro or thoughts with regard to giving away blood or organ donation, totally respect that. Totally respect, yeah, that. But in that corridor, what those people are thinking is good and correct for them, and donating blood in these is good and correct here. We just got to find the journey from one place to the other. And I think Trustainer's going to really create that conversation of making it being culturally safe. We haven't even spoken to our Pasifika contacts yet, you know, all our whānau, our Pasifika whānau, because they don't know a lot about this stuff either. So it's really going to grow. It's really going to grow. But the big thing is, Te Wānanga o Aotearoa, Blood Services and Trustainer got together to create an environment where people feel culturally and physically safe. And it worked. We got this.
You had waiata going, you had singing going.
Mate, we had my mate Nick's down there giving away free sweatshirts. And you know how you have the rows of beds and stuff? We didn't. We had it in a circle. So you got one fella here giving his blood, another fella swabbing to go on. We had we were 30% above our target to get blood from our people. And we had 16 or 17 young Māori men, which is our target, go on the marrow register.
Beautiful.
Huge, man.
Yeah.
And that is, to me,
The ultimate
koha. Yeah. I could write lots of stuff on here, as you can see, but the ultimate koha.
The ultimate gift.
Yeah.
It's beautiful. And that comes down to the work that you and Debs have been doing as well. I mean, how is this helping the two of you?
Grief is on my shoulder all the time.
Yeah.
And with my wahine as well. But the thing is, our boy's name, his legacy, I mean, we lost him when he was 17, okay? But he's doing, his motivation for us is, you know, hopefully saving lives. And there was a Māori fellow, I didn't know who he was. He came in, he was quiet, we give him a cup of tea and all that sort of stuff. And he left and I says, oh, thanks for your love, bro. And he looked at me and he says, I could have saved a life today, eh? And I says, cheer, bro. And you just see this guy glowing, eh? So we're in the business of helping one another. I know it sounds cliche, but it's not a bad space to be in.
Yeah, it's a beautiful space to be in. Oh, nō reira, tēnei te mihi atu ki a koe. Mihi aroha.
Kia ora.
Yeah, e kore rawe e mimiti.
Kia ora.
My love for you and the beautiful wife.
Thanks. Do you guys get food after these all things? just ask.
Did you bring us some, did you say?
I've got it. It's the cake's in the mail.